Ladies and gentlemen, it has been quite a year, but spring is finally here, officially. Technically, officially, I have to just literally do this. I just need the sound to be off, so I don't... I guess settings? Yeah, there we go. Okay. And then... There we go. Yep. Okay. Cool. All right. Cool. But we are finally here. We are finally here with MLB 21. I started. I was like, let me check it out. Let me see what it's about. Let me go everything. Try to figure out everything. And my instant reaction was, I was like, oh, this is a completely different game than plays before. I'm sorry, not plays before, games before. So, and that's the great thing about this new game. The biggest thing about it is genuinely, like, the fact that, English is hard. Why can't I talk today? Okay, focus. So, the biggest thing I see different about this game is that actually having the ability to save the information. So, like, literally, I don't have to go back in here. And, like, let's say I create one character, I don't have to go back in. Do all of this over again to create the exact same character. All I literally have to do is just create one, save it as kind of like the general or like the basic one, and it automatically switches everything over, from skin tone to height and weight differences to even the appearance of the even settings that you have with your uniform or your equipment. So it's a good step up. It's a definitely big step up. And since everything's really the same, I could write, actually this makes my what's the word I'm looking for? This makes my mother flipping. This makes my everything really, my creation video is super short, so I can hop right into content. That's actually really great. So, I mean, kind of, if you want to, like, slow down, pause it, that's great. So I'm going with, like, so basically, also another thing. Now, I don't know if this is the way that the game is designed, or if this is just how, like, there's a way to change this. But, if you notice, it's basically, like pitching style. And now, usually in games like that, it's like, okay, like, in previous modes, the pitching style wouldn't really do anything. It was just there if you happened to be a pitcher. But if you weren't a pitcher, it really didn't matter. Now in the game, you actually have the option to either be a pitcher or a two-way player. But either way, you're pitching. At least that's what I've been seeing, is that you're going to be pitching either way. Which is fine, because pitching, I actually like pitching. I just don't want to make an only pitching thing. Unfortunately, as great as these songs are, we won't have the ability to hear them, purely because of, what's the word I'm looking for? Copyright. There it is. So, I'm going with the good old-fashioned like I did in MLB 20, Cody Bellinger. There's also, you can do generic players, you can do current players, you can do the former players, too. So, I like Cody Bellinger's. Honestly, Cody Bellinger's kind of where mine is. Mine was, when I was, 12, 13, was a Chris Bryant. So, I might switch him to Chris Bryant. Yeah, because that was... Because that's exactly how I used to stand. That's hilarious. I probably changed my... who do they have? Well, obviously, who do they have? But, interesting. I gotta get back into baseball. I really gotta get back into baseball. That's one of the only reasons why I chose Zach Britton. I know John Means, obviously, because Orioles and stuff, but anyway, not the point. All right, cool. So we got that taken care of, music, that's taken care of, equipment. I'm going to switch up my equipment a little bit. I like that. That's fine. That's also fine. I really don't care. You know what? I rocks with the rainbow. Not rocks with the... So stupid. I was saying, I was like, nah, like, I like, Oh, actually, no, this is way better than last year. They really up. So here's the thing. Comparison to last year, a lot of these colors were actually very faded, so it didn't look as well or as spectacular it was supposed to look if you did a custom job like this. They stepped it up very well, where now it's like really, really solid, and the colors are very, they pop out very well. Because it used to be like this. Hold up, if I can angle it properly, which I don't think I can. All right, let me come back over here. All right, so if you kind of look into like the palm, it used to be very super faded. Now they brighten that color, which is definitely adding that extra layer of, let's make this yellow. Let's make this neon yellow. White, pink, green. And then that. That is a beautiful, well put together glove that every single piece is a change thing. You know, honestly, they have to change these. Like, these gloves, they have to change them like every like 2-3 months in the majors, I think. Which is insane. Would it make sense? Because, like, literally, if you're using the same glove, either like really hard speeds or just really for like a number of like 80 games, that's basically just like non-stop using like 80 times, and it's just like overall it just breaks easily, so they have to get a new one like every 2-3 months so they can just like hold it together, which makes sense. And I was like, oh, okay, that's crazy. But anyway, all right, like I said before, we're gonna rock with, I also like color blacks. Let's go with ooh, that red, that's really looking tough. That red is looking tough. That red is looking tough. I can't talk today. Oh, it's so bad. It's so bad. It's so bad. Let me hit him with that good old-fashioned blue. And then they said the team color is what? I don't know. But it's fine. Anyway. I don't know. Anyway, that's fine. Why is there not a color 3? I don't know. Wait, maybe? Just... okay. Then why would there ever be a color 3? Okay. I don't know. Explain to me later, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, Kyle Automatic. Let's do Batring Red. I like the good old fashioned. Well, we could make it, no, let's just make it red. Excuse me for y'all day, Jesus. Alright, we're going to hit him with that both gloves. And, I'm kind of feeling the little, the light blue. That's a lot of colors. Holy crap. That was terrifying. Let me change that, though. Because that was... I've literally put it together, and I was like, holy crap, that was bright. Alright, let's go with that navy. I just like throwing a bunch of colors together and seeing what works and seeing what doesn't. I'm obviously gonna change the gloves because these gloves are kind of dumb. Because I can. I just have to unlock the things. Or lock the equipment first, so we got some time, but those look horrible. But yes. Anyway, hit him with the two head flaps with the Rawlings Mach Pro. Got the chin guard on. Obviously, you gotta protect that chin. Whether you in the octagon or you out here in... I tried to make one-liners. I can't do it. I'm not great at it. It's fine. Oh, Jesus. I just realized you're on. There we go. Yeah, because that's probably not great. But it's fine. It's fine. We're perfectly fine. Worst case scenario, it's just a lot of like, bleh, and I'll just have to re-record the audio. But it's fine. Anyway, not the point. So, get ahead with a normal cap style, as well as a flat brim. Using the elbow guard, yes, but I kind of want to make it large, so I'm just going to, no, might as well. But, either way, You know, genuinely speaking, it's a great game. It's a solid game from what it's worth, from how it started. It's a pretty solid game, all in all. But let's keep it pushing. Let's keep it pushing, keep it moving, and see how it goes. Honestly, like, I'm literally just going with this red-blue style. I really don't know. I just do. Don't wear a running wrist because it's weird. Armbands, no. Wristbands, I have one on the righty. Yeah, with the with the team number, of course. Got you. And then we get to hit with some good old-fashioned sleeves. How about I gonna do? Why not? Why not in neon yellow sleeves? Why not? Why not? Answer me that question. Why not? Why not rock with some, oh, Jesus. Where'd you go? Okay. Both. One, two. There it is. All right, it's cool. No more changes. I'm outside. I don't want to lose that. Eyewear. I used to flip it, but it's fine now. Oh, flip it. Oh, what? That's stupid. It looks the same. I'm so confused. Am I tripping? That's weird. I don't know. Let's do fielding, but keep it flipped. And then... Again, why not? Why not? I will say this till the day that I die. Why not? This I'm fine with. I'll keep... Well, actually, not that. I want to keep it, like, the all clean whites. Why, you may ask, am I wearing all white shoes into a baseball game? Yes, I set myself up for failure on purpose. On purpose. That's going to be it, I think. Yeah, that's it. So, we're all good. Let's keep it pushing. So, we just made our character. We can also change our different poses. I personally like this one because it looks, you know, ready shmitty. And here's the biggest change from years before. The loadout here, ladies and gentlemen. So this is brand new to the actual, what's the word I'm looking for? A brand new whole feature of this thing is called the loadout. So, depending on how you want your player to be, and depending on how, what you like, it's kind of like attribute points and it's kind of like badges, where it's the loadout basically gives a little bit of boost, either temporarily or fully per game. I think it's just per game. So that way, if you want to be a slugger, if you want to be all over, you know, contacts, if you want to be great at fielding, if you want speed, like you want to have a lot of speed. If you want to hit those corners, again, like I said, you can be a two-way player or you can just be a pitcher. So if you just want to be a pitcher, these are the things you want to look for. And then possibly also this one. But if you want to be that two-way player, all of these are needed. All of these are needed. Unless you want, do you want to paint the corners? Do you want to be filthy, just being able to change position? Or just hit them with that good old-fashioned power? So, personally, I'm going to go with, I got to be able to hit good contacts. That's always great for me. Wait, did it not go do what I just, okay. And then, but I'm going to also be able to be a good fielder and a little bit of speed. And then that's going to be my first one. And then my second one, I'm going to do a little bit of, I like being filthy. So I'm going to hit him with the filthy corners, changing directions. Really, but we're also going to be able to, it means we're working on our break, but we also need our good good old-fashioned control. And then one more, because I don't care, just put it as something. I don't care. All right, and then the third one, going to be fielding, going to be fielding, I guess speed and I mean, there's nothing really there. All you can really do besides that is just fielding. All right, but yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. And they also, if you once you get those new upgrades, and then also I could change. Well, I can change those later, so. I don't know what that means. I don't know what activate means. Whatever. Point is, so we're all good to go. I think I have to go back and then use current rosters and then go from there.
With the MLB draft already underway, a young prospect shares his expectations with a former coach.
All right, cool. So, and this year we're not going to do the good old-fashioned draft. All we got to do is just answer a couple questions about where we're going to go, and then we'll see what happens. Cool. All right, so have you been talking to any particular team? I just want to play the ball for the club that wants me the most. There is one team I've heard from more than a couple times. Not really, but I know what type of club I'd like to play for. Personally, I'll probably do two. I'll probably do one for the Orioles if it happens. If not, worst case scenario, you know, I just keep it pushing. Do you have a favorite team pinning your hopes on? Obviously the Orioles, but I'm going to keep it. I'm just going to keep it up to random and see what happens. Nope. I'm going to say no. And that's probably for the best, not yours to decide anyway. Right. I don't want to tie up your line. Good luck, son. All right, let's see what we got.
Carlos,
stepping up to the plate
you
to pick
that
us up.
In your baseball career, what's his world like?
Oh, it's extremely exciting. You know that if you perform, you will get the call.
We've got a developing story here. JP, what are you hearing?
I'm checking the numbers. I'm talking to my sources and my scouts, and they're all telling me, hey, this could actually work.
Most of us mere mortals, when we were that age, we were barely chewing gum and walking at the same time, let alone playing the hardest game there is.
Let's see if he's tough enough mentally here to adapt. That's what good players do.
That dream of getting the big leagues is now becoming reality with that one phone call.
We heading out to San Diego, ladies and gentlemen. We chilling on the West Coast, ladies and gentlemen.
Draft day two wrap-up coverage. Back to the prospect that we mentioned before the break. There was some surprise, even some criticism of the front office over how early he went off the board. Jonathan Mayo, what do you think of this pick?
Man, I don't think any of us saw this one coming. This definitely feels like a reach to me. You know, I had him more as a day three kind of guy. There was a split camp. A lot of scouts disagreed whether he's better as a pitcher or better as a hitter. I'm guessing the team felt that he's got potential on both sides of the ball, and maybe that adds some value to him. But this made me scratch my head a little bit for sure.
All right, Jonathan Mayo, thanks. What about you, Jim Callis? Was this a head-scratcher or the reach of the draft, as some of the other analysts have suggested?
Yeah, you know, I talked to somebody with the team, and they're excited to get this guy. This is a guy they really want. And the two points the club made to me were, one, you know, this whole debate, is he a hitter, is he a pitcher? You know, what are you going to do with him? There was a lot of confusion. This team isn't confused. This team feels like he's got very good potential as a hitter and as a pitcher. They may even try to play him both ways. And they felt like there were a couple other teams that were starting to sniff around this guy. And, you know, this isn't the NFL or NBA draft where you can trade down to get a guy you want. If you want a guy, you have to take him because there's no trades. And they felt like if they didn't take him where they did, somebody else was going to get them, and they just absolutely did not want that to happen.
Jim Callis, we appreciate the time. Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, well. We got to prove some people wrong because a lot of people are calling us overhyped.
Checks in with one of his players.
But we're going to sit down with this. Our manager. I treat the potential as a two-way player. Pitching and position play. I'm game. Let's try it. Do I have to? Well, why not? Why not be a two-way player? Why not be a two-way player? I like it. Somewhere in the infield, somewhere in the outfield, catcher. I'm going to be somewhere in the infield. And I'm thinking third base, because third base is the most. I'm kidding. I think every single base has their own little, like, amount of, like, working together kind of thing. Every base has one. But anyway, we are literally right here. It's so much of a different transition and so much of a different thing, because we're not used to being able to, like, just jump right in and play and, like, play the first game of the season from the jump. So it's like, oh, this is different. But we're cruising through the month of April, because technically our season doesn't start till May. So we're going to take it how we go with it. And certainly as he gets started actually we're going to play our first game against the Corpus Christi. And we're in San Antonio, ladies and gentlemen. San Antonio. How we feeling? San Antonio Missions. Cool, cool, cool. All right. So this is kind of our whole team lineup. I'm not chilling at third base right now. So I love it. I love it. I love it. But anyway, once this game gets started, we'll be good to go.
There is rain in the area, but we've been given a go-ahead to get this one started. Opening night here in this brand new season between the San Antonio Missions and the Corpus Christi Hooks. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next.
Oh. First game of the season. Chad Johnson's on the mound. All right, cool. So we are up to. I don't know why I don't have any of my stuff, but it's fine. But it's fine. We're going to hit him with a good old fashioned. Oof. Hit me with that 12-6 curveball. Why not? Why not go for the homer? Why not go for the homer?
Down the left field line and deep.
All right. I went shorten up. I was like, this is a grand slam opportunity. We're only going for the big dog.
We'll see if he can finish it off. The
0-2. I'll take it though. It dropped where I needed to be. So you got two runs in. So I'll take it.
Hey, one of the things you want to do, Dior, is strike early. And they've done just
first hit in the double A. So we are chilling. We are chilling out here. The fastball? Yeah, that makes sense. It dropped where it needed to drop, which is great.
So next to
hit. Along first base right now, chilling. Chilling. I can't really steal, so I'm just gonna like chill and wait it out. Whatever happens, happens. Give me with a double play. Well, that's unfortunate.
So two runs on two base hits.
On to the next inning. Top of the fourth. Up 2-0. See, we can literally just do contact now. I was like, we're not trying to get anybody on base. Oof. But then again, also don't swing at the first pitch, possibly. But, you know. But if it works, it works.
Now with the plate is Nicholas Stanley. He bounced out last time up. First pitch coming. Here it is. Hit down the third baseline.
Sorry to rip it through that that line, but it's not working. If you have power, you can rip it through it. If you have contact, you gotta go up high. But it's fine. This is the bottom of the seventh. Wow, a lot has happened. We are now down by three. I should have gone for the double play, shouldn't I have? I should have gone for the double play so I can have kept the runner. Oh, that's not great. That's not great at all. All right.
Stanley grounded out in his last at bat. Hit on the ground out to short.
That's a setup for a double play.
Come on.
Never mind. Still set up for an out, though. Jesus. All right.
Jeremy Pena is looking for hit number three here in this at-bat.
Just go first.
Hit on the ground to third.
I was like, just go to first. He's not going to run to third. We'll take it. Of course they get the win. It's all in good fun. First L of the season, but so we're not off to a great start. But we did upgrade our power, did upgrade our clutch, or progress our power and clutch. and a little bit of durability, a little bit of arm strength, a little bit of arm accuracy, and a little bit of fielding. We did get our first double A hit, our at bat and double A hit. And then our clutch kind of also went up too. So, pretty all well first game of the season. And we're probably going to, I'm going to switch out. Oh, I'm not pitching, so. Oh, he even tells you what position, what your next game position is. I like that. That's cool. I respect that. I should have renamed them better, but it's fine.
Welcome into this presentation of Minor League Baseball from the AA Central. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the San Antonio Missions and the Corpus Christi Hooks. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next.
But we're off. I think it's the same guy as before.
Next, it'll be Nicholas Stanley. He drove in two of his club's three runs in last night's affair.
That was a little inside, wasn't it? No, it was just high. It was just high in the strike zone.
To end the inning.
It was just high in the strike zone.
So two out, nobody on, and that brings Corey Lee to the plate. Try to bunt for a base hit.
Charlie
here
down,
gets
bunt.
This one down.
Got him. Oh, took
and
an extra step.
First is they can't make the play on him. Next, it'll be Nicholas Stanley. Flew out last time up. First pitch on its way.
Oof. Almost took off my third baseman coach's head.
Well, you don't need
third
us
base
to tell
coach.
You
there
really
is.
Starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Well, you could say that again, Matt. It's raining cats and dogs out
all right.
There. Make sure
0-2
you
count, 0-2 count. Not bad, not bad. He got me with that little curveball. It's always
right
that curveball that always gets
you. Up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff.
Right.
Maybe expect a fastball.
Was that a curveball? Because I'm not surprised that was a curveball. That was a curveball. That was a dirty, 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 dirty curveball.
Now the pitch.
Ugh.
Jackson.
Yeah, get out.
Look at
thank
it.
You.
And no one will get this one.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot. Time for them to get back in.
All right, wait on it, bro. Wait on it. That was your hit. That was your pitch. The crazy thing. That was your pitch. You start to weigh on it a little bit. Thank you. See? What happens when you weigh on it a little bit? I'm going to see if I can steal, but I don't think I can because I'm not fast enough.
That's only the third hit of the game, and we're getting late into this one.
Yeah, they always say you got to tip your hat.
Get back.
Reactions, and they got him.
Took that extra step. Took that extra step, and it was like, yes.
Right-handed pickoff move is really Hey, it sure feels good to shut
take the L again. One more time around the block. What I might do is, depending on how long the series lengths, or I'm sorry, the episode lengths are, depending on how long they are, I might do either one series per episode or two series. But I might do it like an entire week, just because these games, I know for a fact, I can get through an entire season in a night. So I might just do 1 week, per week kind of thing, per episode. That's cool that I got an icon. I really don't care, but we're gonna look at the schedule. There you are. So we did take the first three L's. We're gonna finish up. We're going to do this series too as well, because by that time we'll be done. We'll be right into next week. So we're going to play into the next appearance. All right, there we go.
A double A hitting coach touches base with a new arrival to the team.
Nick, if you're looking to maximize your development as a hitter, the batting cage is open on off days too. Cool. Great. Your off days are your own, but every bit of your extra time can commit to developing your bat skills will make a difference. Give it a try. I shall do it.
All
right, so we're going to go to our default loadout, and We're currently 0-3. They're currently 3-0. I think these are the same guys that we just played. Yeah, these are the exact same guys. But now it's just probably either home or away.
Future stars are on display as Minor League Baseball comes your way on the show. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the Corpus Christi Hooks and the San Antonio Missions.
Now,
it's baseball. It's the show, and it comes your way next.
Well, and we're off to the races, ladies and gentlemen.
Lake Backer gets the ball for the
opener. We got, his name is Lake. I don't really know.
Late now is the designated hitter, Nicholas Stanley, who's back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game.
What a beautiful hit, ladies and gentlemen. Let's track down.